My name is David Driscoll, and I'm from Chicago, Illinois. I got started with brain education because I was looking for a job, and I had tried yoga before, and I found a lot of benefits from it. And when I saw a listing to help out at a yoga center, I was like, this is perfect. I can do this part-time and continue breakdancing and get ready for grad school. And so I took that job. So I went to Princeton, I went to an Ivy League college, and I tried a lot of different things. I did some sports, obviously study, I did music, and I did dance, I did a lot of stuff. But throughout it all, it was exciting, but I felt a lack of kind of conviction. Like, this is something I want to do with the rest of my life, and it's going to make a difference. Because honestly, a lot of it was using the brain, but not necessarily using your heart. And I felt something missing. I really did. I respected the people that I was with too, but none of them really asked for my 100%, like my heart and soul, as well as my brain. And I left college feeling like, you know, it's not worth it. Working hard, being smart, being creative. So what? Does it really help the world? Does it really satisfy me? So when I found brain education through body and brain, one of the things, first of all, I loved the physical practice because it made my body feel better and also made my brain felt like it was working better. I knew I had this potential because there had been moments where athletically or creatively, it was like firing on all cylinders. But there were many moments when it didn't work, and I wanted to know why my brain worked sometimes and not others. So I found that. Physically, I also found it was helping my body to feel healthy. That was really good. But more than anything else, the people that I met through body and brain, in a very simple, very friendly way, they were able to challenge me more than anybody else in my life, even at an Ivy League college. And I respected that because I think at some level, I wanted to be able to challenge people, to ask them to give their 100% instead of just, okay, this is our goal and do it in whatever way you can figure out that's going to be easiest. Because I don't think the world really needs more of that. It needs more of people giving their heart and soul to solve the problems. So I met a lot of people like that through body and brain. I really respected it. And also they challenged me a lot because I was used to just using kind of intelligence or creativity to solve problems instead of having to really open up and be sincere and use my 100%. My greatest change through brain education has been being able to really trust myself, encourage myself, and also just believe in what I want, what I'm doing. My favorite brain education exercise would probably be Sleeping Tiger, because for me that works physically, mentally, emotionally. I really think it's just like the best you can do at one time. So I found brain education through the Body and Brain Centers, and they're all over the country. And if you'd like to find one for yourself, there'll be a link in the description. Knowing what I know now, I would tell my old self to invest the time to get to know yourself better. You don't have to work too hard just to kind of succeed or satisfy other people's expectations, but not just thinking about it, but spending the time to focus on yourself. So I was an Ivy League graduate who lacked direction, and through brain education, I found conviction in my purpose and confidence in my life.